All right, we're going to look at how to make our birdhouse, how to do things like look at our box and everything. So one thing I wanted to show you is what your final drawing might be. So this drawing here would get me this assembly. So in this assembly, you can see I have like a top part. If you look in the browser, you can see what I'm highlighting as well. So a top part and then a left side, which is the same as the right side, and then a bottom, and then there's a back part as well. And you can see the finger joints and the holes and everything in there. And so there's that. And then this drawing sheet would give me all five of those. So I'm going to have the two sides and then the top and bottom and the back part. And so if I'm going to make my box, and then here's just the different part files individually is what I wanted to show you. But if I'm going to make some sort of box like this for my birdhouse design, I'm going to start maybe with a base. And let's say my base is going to be like a 6x4. So probably a good idea to just draw your base in that plane that it stays in and to really think about where you're at. And so let's say the bottom base is 6x4. So 6 inches by 4 inches. And then when we extrude it up, it's only going to come up 1/8 of an inch because that's how thick our Econo wood is, right? And so that is our like base and everything's going to go on that. So 4-inch side walls will be on the side here and here. And we'd have maybe 6-inch walls in the front and back, maybe the holes here and different features on that, of course. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start putting slots into this for my other pieces to like slide into. So the first thing to note is, of course, you know, it's going to be like a rectangular slot probably. You're going to come here and the width of that slot is going to be 1/8 of an inch, the exact thickness of the actual Econo wood. So 1/8 of an inch. And then maybe I want my slots to be 3/4 of an inch. Size. Okay. Now I've made the size of that, but I need to locate it. And so let's say I want to maybe start my first one, maybe 1/4 of an inch from here. And then the amount in, maybe I only want to make that, you know, if you think about it, if you make there be any distance here, right? If there's any distance here, like let's say I make it 1/8 of an inch, which is also 0.125. Okay. What that's going to do is there's going to be an overhang when I put my board here. Now, interestingly enough, I could just make this 0. That's going to put it right on the edge. And then my slots will be right on the edge, and it'll be a clean fit, just like this assembly here. But if I wanted this to overhang at all, for whatever reason, I could not do that. So maybe I'll just come back here and this 0, I'll come back to this 0 here, and I'll click on that. And so I undid it, come back in, and maybe I'm going to leave that as 1/8 of an inch. So there will be that 1/8 of an inch overhang. Okay, so then the actual thickness of the box, if you think about it, the opening is going to be much smaller. It would be 1/8 of an inch less here, plus another 1/8 of an inch. So it would actually be 1/4 of an inch less in size. But we'll talk more about that in a minute. Okay, so we've got that. And then I want to you know, cut that out. So I'm just going to do an extrude. I'm going to choose that feature. And I'm going to do a cut. And I'm just going to say, you know, all the way through and hit OK. And then I'm going to do a rectangular pattern of that cut along this edge, and I want to go the other direction, so I'd turn it the other way. And let's say, you know, that's from start to start 1 inch for each. Let's make it 2 inches for each. Nah, that might be too much. Let's make it 1.5 inches for each, and let's do 3 of them. Ooh, and that went too far, didn't it? So what I could do is I could make it 1.25 inches per each, maybe. I make it 1.25 inches and I do 3 of them, it looks like I'm good to go. And if you think about it, if I did 1.25 inches, that means from here to here is 1.25 inches, and then from here to here is 1.25 inches, so that's 2.5 inches, right? And then this is 1/4 inch, this is 3/4 of an inch, so that's 3.5, and then so there's room there that's a little bit more even. And so if I wanted to make that evened out, I would have to do the math, and I have to really just figure out how far is this distance, and how many of these do I want? Okay, and so you could do the math in that and figure it out that way. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and okay. And then I could put like a work plane in parallel between mid plane between two planes. I could put it in between this plane and this plane over here. And that's gonna get me a plane right in the middle. And then now I could mirror this extrusion and this pattern over this plane. And now those cuts would be on the other side as well. Okay, now I've got my first one. I could put the cuts in the front and the back as well, but we'll leave that for another video.